Hey all, how have you been? Hope you all are doing good. In today's video, I wanted to talk about few simple habits that I have incorporated in my life and it has made such a big difference. It could be something which you would already be doing or it may be something which your subconscious mind knew but have never thought of adding it to your lives. Both ways, I hope it gives you some motivation and ideas of leading a healthy and happy life. And let's begin with the video. Waking up when your alarm goes off. How many of you are in the habit of snoozing your alarm? I always did it for years and felt so guilty for ruining the day just because I missed out on that precious peaceful morning hours. The trick which worked for me is to not snooze the alarm dedicatedly and jump out of the bed as soon as the alarm rings. You will feel like a zombie in the first moment. A minute later, everything will be fine and you will thank yourself for not snoozing the alarm, I promise. Not checking my phone first thing in the morning. Another big bad habit that I have got rid of is wasting my time on my phone as soon as I woke up. And unintentionally, this little habit turned my whole day upside down. I realized mornings are the best time to breathe in some fresh air, to exercise, walk, meditate, or just do things that makes us feel good about ourselves. Drinking a lot of water. I swear by this one, a lot of our health, skin and mental stress at times is due to not having enough water. This is such a basic thing but often we don't realize it. Having a glass of water as soon as I wake up is something I never forget to do. Water helps to reduce headaches, tiredness, makes your skin acne free and glowing. Try to fill a bottle of water and make it a habit to finish and refill it throughout the day. One of the habits that has really changed the way I feel about myself is my morning skincare routine. If you have seen my initial YouTube videos, you would have noticed that I had very dry white patches, acne prone and a very dull skin. I had been purely lazy with my morning skincare for some time, which had led to this issue. Recently, Plum Goodness sent me a pack of their green tea range, which I heard is very effective in combating all the skin-related issues I had been facing. So I have now started incorporating their 3-step morning routine as a part of my daily schedule. The routine consists of first scrubbing my face with a green tea-based face scrub. The Gentle Revival face scrub is sulfate-free, water-based face scrub for oily skin that provides gentle yet effective exfoliation. Green tea is a natural antioxidant that combats acne. I follow this up with a clear face mask which I apply as a thin layer and keep on for 30 minutes. This mask has green tea extracts to combat acne and the natural clay absorbs excess oil. I guess this is the best for oily skin. Once the 30 minutes are over, I wash it off with cold water and move on to the final step of the morning skincare, which is the oil-free moisturizer. It contains hyaluronic acid, niacinamide that will control oiliness and prevent breakouts. It also has squalane and kakadu plum, which are natural moisturizers. You can also earn reward points by sending in your Plum empties. Check their empties for good initiative on this link. What more, Plum has provided this special coupon code just for my viewers to avail 10% off on the green tea range of products on the Plum website. Use my code GTDIA10 to avail this offer. I would recommend you never skip your morning skincare regime to give your skin the attention it deserves. Desi cow's A2 milk. This is something I have recently started. It's been a year now. Apparently, the milk we get in the market is mostly adulterated no matter what they claim on the packets and ads. A pure cow's milk is what which comes from the farm directly and is called A2 cow's milk. There are some farms which I trust and after a lot of research have finally found out about them. I will link them down in the description for you. This is also the best form of milk which you can give to your babies with a peace of mind. I personally would recommend you not to have milk at all if you aren't able to have the right milk and doing yourself more loss than gain. There are many other form of milk products like paneer, curd, etc. or other protein source to substitute milk. recycling milk packets. When we get our milk in these plastic packets, a little that we can do from our side is to cut these packets halfway and not fully to snip it off. This process ensures that the small plastic pieces do not get missed in the process of recycling and do not end up polluting or going to a landfill. Meal prep and plan. This is something I have been doing for a while now and I can't thank myself enough for this change. It makes life so easy, organized, and I started to cook a lot more at home than before. For example, we were craving for some pav bhaji and instead of ordering, I thought I would meal prep the ingredients today and I'm going to make it tomorrow for evening snack. Or making ginger garlic paste or tomato chutney in advance. I get a lot of questions asking, is cut vegetables healthy? So the answer is yes, it is, as long as we are cutting and storing it the right way. The amount of loss of nutrients is determined by the storage temperature and the length of the time the food remains exposed to the air. Use a sharp knife and store it in an airtight container at or below 4 degrees Celsius as soon as you are done chopping them. Fresh food loses vitamins and minerals over time while freezing preserves nutrients. At the end, it's all up to your preference and time. Use a bowl for collecting vegetable peels. This is something I've been doing for very long and I think it's a great way to keep your kitchen countertop clean. It makes cleaning easy and cooking mess-free, so why not? Switching to cast iron cookware. I have spoken about this in a lot of my videos but never got to make a detailed video about this. I have invested in a few cast iron utensils since a year now and I have been loving it. It's not only healthy but also sustainable and worth the buy because this is literally indestructible and will last you forever. Also, if seasoned and oiled properly after every use, it tends to act like a nonstick with regular use. Few cons are it is heavier than nonstick and has to be oiled after every use. Lot of people have varied opinions about cast iron care and tips. The easiest way I found to wash it is to use less dish detergent than normal, scrub it well and not put it in the dishwasher. Then wipe it immediately and put it on the gas flame to dry it completely before oiling it properly. Investing in the right pressure cooker. We all know how important is a pressure cooker in Indian cooking. This aluminium cooker has been used by me for the past 5 years now. I have used it 365 days and still love it. However, recently I decided to finally switch it for a steel pressure cooker because of the harmful health hazard that cooking in aluminium has. I can peacefully cook in it without thinking about anything leaching into the food. The best part is it's also dishwasher safe, unlike aluminium cookers. Cooking in mustard oil. Mustard oil has been used in Indian cooking for decades. I have seen my grandma and my mom swear by it. For every health problem, it was mustard oil which came to the rescue. However, there have been recent debate to whether or not it is good for the heart. To which I have recently researched and found out on the contrary, mustard oil has multiple health benefits than one. It also cures many diseases related to skin, joint, muscles and heart. Then again, consumption of anything in high quantity is harmful. Also, it's recommended to use the kachi ghani or unrefined mustard oil. Happiness is homemade. I can't stress enough about this point. There was a time I used to hate cooking and ordered food very often, mostly because the food I made didn't turn out well and I felt demotivated. But with time and practice, I have learned a lot, and cooking at home has become a habit. It's tasty, healthy, and affordable. Like, for instance, making biryani at home, there are so many ways to make biryani, and the best part of making homemade is you can customize it according to your family's needs. Also, making your own homemade idli or dosa batter. It's not only healthy but also stays fresh in the fridge for a week, unlike the packaged ones which usually starts to smell bad in a day or two. In fact, you could also try to make ghee at home. It is not tough but needs some practice. When the ghee cools down, it will solidify into something like this. Or making your own curd at home, because it's cheaper, healthier, and tastier. Drying mixer jars properly. A lot of times, if you have noticed, our mixer grinder jars smell very bad. When we wash these jars, whether we hand wash it or put it in the dishwasher, I normally let it air dry on a drying mat overnight and the next day. This process helps to eliminate any bad odor and will help to keep them in good condition for years. Get rid of phone addiction. Few ways that has helped me is to keep my phone away from me. For example, if I am in the kitchen cooking, I will leave my phone in the bedroom. That ways I will not grab my phone in between my cooking breaks, or using a notepad and pen for jotting down instead of using the phone. Or turning off notification for apps that's not important. Or keeping ourselves busy with a hobby or learning a new skill, etc. These things really helps when in today's digital world it's very hard to resist ourselves from aimlessly scrolling on our phones. Quick tidy up before bed. This habit has been there with me since long, and I can assure waking up to a tidy house takes half stress away no matter what. It takes me about 5 minutes to quickly tidy up the living room and dining table. I put back things in their right places. I also tidy up Kaya's room with her since she has her school online classes the next morning. Five minutes of daily kitchen cleaning. Here's a tip. Dish detergent is a great degreaser, and when it comes to a quick cleaning after every meal, this cannot get better. You can use it to clean any surface in your kitchen and it will be all sparkly clean within no time. This is one of the best ways you can keep your kitchen neat and clean every single day. Control urge of ordering out. For me, I realized prior meal prep really helps with ordering outside food. I'm not saying I don't go for food deliveries, we love it once in a while, but on regular basis, it may not be a good habit both for our tummy and pockets. For example, making pav bhaji at home is not only healthy and tasty, but it's also easy. Now, isn't this looking authentic street style? Having an early dinner. I have regretted in my past for this, and still at times it doesn't happen. However, having a late dinner has a very bad effect on our body in a lot of ways. What works for me is to start prepping for dinner before hunger strikes and have dinner not later than 8:30, which is also kind of late, but we are slowly getting there. Another tip is to not have any heavy snack in the evening, because that ways we are likely to have something unhealthy. This will automatically make us full and we would have dinner late. And that's all for today's one. Hope this video helps you in some way and reminds you of habits that are worth adding to our lives, which may make a big difference. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon with a new one. Bye.